Yeah, I mean, as always, I thank people for coming out. Hopefully people had fun in McLeod. I think a lot of people were probably there on Saturday and Sunday. Big win yesterday. I got to go to the game. I think wrestling crowd's just a little more rowdy, though. I'm just going to tell you. That's a good thing, though. Basketball, they get into it a little bit, too. But, man, I'm watching the coaches, and, I mean, they get to walk on the court. Like, and they get to go up and down, and man, we give up points if we do that. Like, I don't, man, we got to figure out something go more with basketball. Man, they're way too lenient on their coaches, though. I'm going to say that because, man, we get it. We get hammered a lot more than those guys. And Jake's staff, I'm thinking about the next time for my staff, too. We're going to have matching outfits, kind of like that. I think we'd look good as a matching. I think we'd look pretty good. But it was obviously a fun meet for us. I'll tell you this, and most important to me is how we respond to things. You know, I talk about South Dakota State, and you know, I remember that night talking about that. Now this can be a point where we use and we move forward, and we're better for it. You know, you don't ever like to get your tail kicked, but some of the things that I think that we emphasized or that we displayed on Saturday, the hustle, the fight, just kind of sometimes the one more effort, being incredibly excited and looking forward to competing. I think we did that, you know, to a man. And that's just got to happen every time. I think that's got to be a hallmark of our program. And I've talked about a team, like, that's one thing that checked off our box every time. Every single time we step out there, we will give 420 seconds. We will fight from start to finish. We will give the extra effort. And not for us. You know, I mean, for each other, for our team, for something bigger than us, for just a pride that we have in one another in the program. And, you know, you saw that, and you saw guys really step up to the occasion, and that's fun to see. It's fun to see guys be excited, and you know, I mean, those moments, they don't come very often. So enjoying those moments and really looking forward to them, and then also then getting back to the big picture. You know, I think that's something as a coach, you gotta be able to stay in that. You gotta stay in the moment and be aware and keep them in the moment, but then you also gotta kind of have the big picture in mind. That's what we're trying to do with our guys. We're trying to keep them in the moment as much as possible, put absolutely everything they possibly can into their practices, into their life, and then go out and compete their tails off, and then whatever happens, we learn from it and we move forward. And I think our guys are doing a good job of that. So obviously a big win for our program. Whenever you go that long without beating a team, I guess it's a big win, you know. I'll tell you this, and they're a good team, and if anybody watched them wrestle on Sunday, you know, I hear coaches like, oh, you know, it was a bad day for them, good day for us. You know, whatever it is, man, like, you know the date on the calendar, and it's your job to go perform. But I'll say that they responded the next day, and they're a good program, and they will have their guys more ready, or their guys will get themselves more ready moving forward. So it's good for us because we have some momentum as a team, but the only way you keep momentum as a team is you got to continue to perform like that. You got to continue to train like that. You got to have that energy in the practice room and that excitement in the practice room too, because that carries over. But man, to say that I'm not happy with how we perform, I mean, that'd be a lie, because I was happy with how we performed, but can there be more? Absolutely. And that'll be the case till I'm done, till I'm done coaching. And our guys feel that too, but man, you get some good things that happen. You know, you get a guy that, you know, 57 that steps up in a match, and man, there's a lot of situations in that match that could have went either way, and he just fought his tail off in every single one of them. And that's, to me, that had nothing to do with, you know, skill-wise, that had to do with a choice, with an attitude, with something bigger than themselves and that they're buying into. And that they're going to go fight for each other. They're going to go fight for the fans. They're going to go fight for, you know, we got a couple people that are sitting in the crowd that they're fighting. They're literally fighting for their lives right now that are part of our program. And if we can't find a little bit extra and dig a little bit extra deep for those people, then, you know, like we talk about, then something's wrong. And I think those guys found that, and they just got to continue to find it. You know, match by match, you know, 25, that's the best match that he's wrestled against that guy. I think if you saw the match, I mean, he had to turn him in. I think he was very, very close to getting his cradle, very close to getting his cradle early on, and they were on the edge, and he kind of had to try to turn him on. But, you know, riding that guy for a long time and then just kind of really expending himself. I mean, Shorm was exhausted after that match, which is good, but he was still able to compete and still able to function, and that's something we've been trying to work him through. So even though that's a loss, there's a lot of positive and a ton to build off of. Skidlarzik, big win, you know, kind of be able to swing the tide and doing a great job on top. I mean, four back points, that's huge, and then getting the last score, always big to finish on top. Mikey, you're a good competitor and you're composed. You're a good competitor and composed. Like, I know sometimes, freshman, senior, sophomore, junior, anywhere, you know, if you're a good competitor, you can compete, and he's already ready, man. He's competing at a really high level right now. Finding ways and sticking with positions, and that guy was really sticky on top, and he had to work his tail off to get that reversal. But he kept working on it. It was like a 40-second process, so he stuck with it. And finish that match off. Max, and I'll put, man, I should have challenged, absolutely. I don't know if I've ever seen, I've coached for a long time, and have the second official give points. It doesn't happen very often, very, very rarely. So I should have challenged that because I didn't think it was, but the side judge was so adamant that he had the points, I didn't challenge it. But, you know, you still have 3 minutes of the match, you know, so got to be able to get away from the guy, obviously, which he was able to do in the third period. And, you know, those matches can get turned around. But you know what? I should have challenged right away because, man, I was almost in shock. That I was like, where did those points come from? Because I never saw you count anything. And the side guy's like, well, I saw him. And I'm like, well, boy, you must have left your glasses at home because, man, I didn't see it. And I think afterwards when you watch, you know, I mean, obviously it wasn't there, but you know what? I shouldn't dwell too much on that because, you know, you have a lot of time. But another lesson Max has learned, and you know what? I mean, next time we have to make an adjustment in how we're going to get off the bottom. 57, big match, competed his tail off, hit some really explosive holds, a lot of mat returns. You know, we had a ton of mat returns throughout the match, and that's just effort. That's all that is. I mean, mat returning a guy is just so much about effort. And, you know, and he put a lot of effort into that match. 65, just got manhandled in some situations, you know, and we got out hand fought. And if you've been watching Yant wrestle, I mean, part of what he does, he fights his tail off. He stays in that fight. He keeps the guy on his back foot. And that guy was able to do that to him a little bit. And, you know, sometimes when the guy brings the fight to you, then you have to up your level. I'm going to bring the fight back to him. And then he ups the ante a little bit. Then I got to up that ante a little bit. And that's just, it's a good lesson to learn. And I know next time when that guy ups his level, he'll do the same back to him. 74, man, that's a good match. You beat a good guy. You beat a guy that's a couple-time All-American and beat him handily and dominated really every position. Rode him, turned him, took him down multiple times, hit some great attacks. You know, that was a really good match from Steyert. And Steyert's wrestling incredibly well right now. You know, I didn't think anybody that's watching to be like, well, this guy, I mean, because he's about every match, he's scoring 10, 12, 14 points, and the other guy's scoring maybe one or two. You know, we just got to keep it rolling. Luhan put a man right on the guy. I mean, that third period, and that's something that he's going to have to do moving forward, too. Sometimes you got to be able to ride a guy. Sometimes, you know, I know everyone's kind of like, I want to see something exciting out of Luhan. And you know what? Sometimes the match doesn't, how it dictates, that just doesn't happen. Especially when a guy is trying to keep things close. Sometimes you take your opportunities when they're there, and then, you know, you win a match 4-0. So good for him. Glazer, we've kind of said it all year. I mean, he goes out and he fights just, you know, he's not a full 97 pounder, obviously. And he's been wrestling some really good 97 pounders. Didn't give up a pin. I mean, to me, those are positive. That's a point that could have went their way and it didn't. And then Carter closed the match out. Good job by him. Good for our team. Our team felt good about it. But one thing I remind them is that we got Oklahoma on Saturday. And that's the next most important thing. And really the next and most important thing for them was Saturday night, taking care of themselves, getting good sleep, rest, and nutrition. Sunday, the same thing. And then, you know, getting themselves back to work. But we certainly have momentum to build on, and some excitement. I think hopefully we made a few new fans. You know, I know a lot of people don't get a chance maybe to get to the West Gym just because of the atmosphere, because it's small, and maybe some people don't like that. They like these seats a little bit better. They're a little more comfortable. They like to be able to have the brew flowing, and you know, I mean, I liked McLeod this time. Last time, not so much. And maybe the result had a little bit to do with that. But also, when you start getting 4,000 or 5,000, 6,000 people, there's a lot of energy in a building. It's exciting and it's fun, and especially I think the way our guys competed, they made it so the atmosphere was like that. I think when you have exciting matches and you have guys fighting their rear ends off from start to finish, I think it's hard for people not to be engaged. And I think people got engaged in that match. They were into the match, and hopefully look forward to our senior day against West Virginia, which will be in the West Gym. And, you know, you talk about the senior class, and I was talking, you know, I listened to the swimming coach talk about the senior class a little bit and their senior class and how they left it in a better place. And there's no doubt that our senior class has left things in a better place. Their job's not done yet, and their season's not done yet, and their impact on the program isn't done yet. But, you know, that was one thing they wanted to check off their box. They wanted to beat Oklahoma State in a duel, and they were able to do it. Now there's some other things that you want to be able to beat them into. And not just them, just everybody. But we look forward to Oklahoma, and you know, they have a solid team up and down. And we'll be ready for it. We got big matches at 33, big matches at 41, 57, 74, 97. I mean, those guys are all in the rankings. So we got to get back up and ready and perform at an incredibly high level again on Saturday. So anything else? Yep. Well, first off, 6,000. Let's just go right there. Let's get 6,000. Because I saw Jake. I think that's what Jake's been talking about. Let's get 6,000. Because 4,000, it was great. I mean, there was good energy. But 6,000, then people got to stand up top. They got to stand everywhere. There's no seats. You can't see any purple, right? Unless they're wearing a purple shirt. Yeah, I mean, it's certainly something that we'll look forward or look at doing, you know, in the future. But I think it's case by case, you know, and we'll play it year by year. And you know, I had some people ask, you know, what can we do to get, you know, we want some things over in the West Gym that we don't have. You know, what can we do to do that stuff? And, you know, that's stuff that we'll figure out. But, man, I think if we can ever get more people hooked and into a wrestling meet and into that environment, then, you know, that's part of what we want to do. We want to expand. I mean, we have our fans that will be there, and they'll be in there, and they'll be in line an hour and 15 minutes before because they want their seats, you know, but be able to kind of pull some of the fringes, then, you know, I think we do have to do something like that. You know, if it's once a year or once every couple years, or, you know, let's get to where we're sold out in season tickets yet. We haven't even sold out in season tickets in the West Gym. Let's do that first. Once we do that, then you're like, well, we can't even hold anything in this. Because I think it's crazy that we don't have, why can't we have 5,000? Why can't we average 6,000 for a meet? You see what Penn State does. You see what I was doing right now. So we just got to continue to put a better product out there, and then I know the people will come. So I don't know if I'm dodging your question or answering your question, or do I love the West Gym? Absolutely. But in any environment where we can get more you and I wrestling fans hooked and get them to see our team and how they compete, then yeah, then I'm all for it. Yeah.
Can you put your finger on maybe one particular thing that's made the change in the team since then?
I'm making up their mind. Are you going to fight? Are you going to fight the whole time or not? Man, it's simple. What changed? I mean, even from the Missouri meet, it's like, what changed? You can't change a whole lot in 2 days, but you can change your mentality and attitude. You can change on what you're focusing on, right? If I'm focusing on winning, then... yeah, then a lot of times they slip right through your hands, right? I mean, you could say, you watch a basketball game yesterday, I mean, you start focusing on winning, you focus on executing, right? You focus on the next possession or the next situation, that's it. And you make it that simple. And I think our guys are doing that. They're buying into the extra effort and that what that does and how that multiplies over time. How one mat return and two mat returns and three mat returns, what that turns into for that opponent. What, one snap or two snaps, or hey, I just stay in there and the guy thinks he's going to get something, he doesn't get it, how that adds up over time. And then that doesn't just add up in that match, it adds up in the next match too, because all of your guys are seeing it, all your team's seeing it. It's like, I'm going out and competing that way, you know what, well, damn right, I'm going to do it too. I'm not going to be the guy. I'm not going to be the one that's not going to go out and fight. Are you kidding me? I'm not going to be that guy. And I would say that's more. Sometimes you got to have, you know, that meeting where it's like, okay, boys, what are we going to do here? How are we going to move forward? What are we going to do? We got a choice. And I won't say they've chosen the easier path, because it's not easier. Actually, you got to choose the hard path over and over again to be able to have those results. So, man, if anything, they've chosen the hard path, and they went out and going to fight for each other and something bigger than themselves, and they just got to continue to do it. So, yeah. Maybe there's more questions. Who knows? Maybe. I'm kidding. All right, go Panthers.